Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. If you're into digital photography and want to elevate your photos to a level you never thought you could, I have two words for you. Get Optics. It is without a doubt the best Photoshop plugin I ever used. A few weeks ago, I showed you an overview of Boris FX Optics. In that video, I showed how I quickly transformed this daytime photo into a dramatic nighttime scene, as well as how I made this 1940s style film noir portrait. Both were created exclusively within the Optics plugin. This time, I'll show you how I quickly use camera lens distortion and add photographic light leaks to them, how to add lightning and drama to stormy skies, how to create gun muzzle flashes, and make customizable vintage video interference. If you decide you'd like to add the Optics plugin to Photoshop, or to Lightroom, or just to use it as a standalone application, Boris FX that makes Optics is offering my viewers 15% off when you click the special link in my video's description and use the code BLTV2020. So what is Optics? Optics is a collection of 160 visual effects with thousands of customizable presets. It includes 75 legendary Sapphire filters used by visual effects artists in some of Hollywood's biggest blockbusters. Once Optics installs into Photoshop, convert your photo into a smart object so you can modify it non-destructively. To open Optics, go to Filter, Boris FX, and Optics. The interface is quite easy to navigate. On the left are the layers, similar to Photoshop. The bottom layer will always be your original photo. Running along the bottom are the 9 filter categories. In addition, there's the custom category, to which you can save your own custom preset, as well as favorites, to which you can add your favorite presets. Each category shows its various filter effects, which are fully customizable. For this photo, I'd like to use a fisheye type of lens to warp the surfer, so I'll click the lens category and click the S Warp Magnify filter. By the way, whenever you see a filter that has an S at the beginning of the name, you know it's a Sapphire filter, which most visual effects artists consider to be one of the best, if not the best filter for photos in the world. On the right are all the presets within that particular filter effect. For this image, I use the default preset. By clicking Parameters, we can customize the effect. I created this image after applying just 3 filters. In the first layer above the original, I warped the surfer into a kind of fisheye perspective. I'll double-click it to open the category I used, which is the S Warp Magnify effect. The preset I used was the default filter. I'll open its parameters and check all of the guides so we can see them. By dragging the magnify amount, we can adjust the center magnification. By dragging the lens edge width, we can adjust the outer magnification. In the next layer, I added a sun. In the light category, I'll click S Lens Flare, open its presets, and click the default filter. I'll open its parameters and adjust its overall scale width and brightness. Lastly, I added light leaks. This time, I'll click S Light Leak. I'll click Presets and click the Big, Bright, Fast, and Warm preset. I'll open its parameters and adjust its size and shift its hue. Once we're happy with our image, click the gear icon to save it. Since it's saved as a smart filter, we can readjust any of the filters by just double-clicking the Optics Smart Filter to open it back up. In the next image, I made an existing stormy sky more ominous and dramatic by adding lightning, adjusting its color and contrast, and by adding a blurred vignette around the inside perimeter of the photo. In the first layer, I added lightning. In the Render category, I clicked S Zap. I used the default filter and opened its parameters. We can adjust the amount of bolts and adjust its arcs by showing the spline of the lightning. To undo any steps, just press Ctrl or Command Z, just like in Photoshop. Once we like the way the arcs of the lightning look, we can hide the spline. We can adjust the pointiness of the ends of the bolts, their randomness, their wrinkle amplitude, the curve amplitude, the amount of branches off the main bolt, the angles of the branches, their lengths, the brightness of the glow, and virtually every other visual aspect of our lightning. The next layer addresses the particular color and contrast I wanted for this image. In the color category, I used the haze effect and the haze 5 filter. We can adjust how clear or hazy we want our image to be, as well as shifting its color temperature. In the top layer, I gave this gothic image landscape an ethereal blurred vignette. In the diffusion blurs category, I clicked the center spot effect and the center spot 1 preset. We can increase or decrease the amount of blur, adjust the spot's aspect, its radius, and its falloff radius. To save it, click the gear icon. In the next image, I added a gun muzzle flash to the end of the gun barrel. I'll double-click the first layer effect to open it. In the render category, I use the S muzzle flash effect and the Beretta filter. By the way, there are 19 fully customizable gun muzzle filters, including shotgun blasts, pulse cannons, and alien death rays. We can adjust the angle of its elevation to match the elevation of the gun. To reposition it, just drag the center crosshair. We also can adjust the angle of elevation by dragging its axis guide. We can adjust the flash's rotation to match the rotation of the gun. I'll fast forward to show how the different filter settings affect it. I'll open the second muzzle flash that I added. I'll position it and adjust its elevation and brightness. If you want your image to go back to its original default effect, click the big X to revert it back, and when you see this message, click No. In this last image, I'll show you how you can transform a photo into the look of an old-school video glitch freeze frame with just one click. Check out all the customizable effects you can use in the stylized category. I'll click S TV Damage and the Occult TV Filter. Voila! It instantly transformed the photo into a classic vintage video portrait. If you decide you'd like to play with its parameters, just open it up and have fun experimenting with them. We can add some additional video interference by clicking this icon to add a new layer. I'll click the S Parallax Strips effect to see how this looks. I'll use its default preset and play with its parameters. Let's see how another stylized filter looks. I'll click the S Digital Damage effect, use its default preset, and play with its parameters. I hope I was able to give you an idea how optics can enhance and elevate your photos. There are so many ways you can transform your photos into stunning images, all with an optics, and often with just one click. Remember to take advantage of the 15% discount that Boris FX is offering to my viewers. Just click the special link in my video description and remember to type in the code BLTV2020. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.